Part of the chapter in Basic Marine Instrumentation is Hydrographic Survey. In this chapter, we will discuss briefly about it, which cover the definition, the chart, and applications. Hydrography is a branch of applied sciences which generally refers to the measurement and description of physical features of any water bodies. In ancient Greek, hydro means water and graphy means to write, or it should be more suited with to illustrate or to map in hydrography. Hydrography works also helps in prediction of water area changes over time. Maybe some of the changes come from erosion or sedimentation, which lead to the depth differences over time. Or maybe sometimes caused by a natural disaster that might have changed major structure or background at a particular place. Okay, that was the definition of hydrography. When we talk about hydrography, there will always a ship pictures come into our mind. Big ships or small ships, and even an old ship like in this picture. It doesn't matter, because the objective of hydrography is initially to map the sea for vessel navigation. All sailors want safe navigation, safe maneuver while sailing or sea exploration. From the hydrography parts that we need for vessel navigation, we also necessarily need the survey. Then after that, it comes other marine purposes and activities. There are 5 parameters in hydrographic survey that need to be considered. There are time and position, depth of water, geographic location, and bottom types. All these parameters will help cartographer to portray the surveyed part of the Earth's surface on a flat piece of paper. And last but not least, and very important, is the prediction service by the hydrography. It involves geodesy, physical oceanography, marine geology, geophysics, photogrammetry, remote sensing, and marine cartography. So after the survey was carried out, this is what we got, the bathymetric surfaces, where it shows the underwater features with respect to the depth observed. We can do all this by the help of some instrument like echosounder. An echosounder is a sound-based instrument that we can use underwater, where sound is the best sense to work in that medium. The result can be utilized as much as we have on land, where we have for our route navigation like Google Map or Waze application. We only have to set our origin and then the destination, and it will suggest you few selection of routes such as fastest or shortest routes, void tolls or motorways or dirt roads, and other settings that was provided in it. So what's left for us in consideration of water road is a nautical chart. It is a working document for mariners. It may show depths of water and heights of land, natural features of seabed, details of the coastline, navigational hazards, location of natural and man-made that aid to navigation, information on tides and current, local details of earth magnetic field, and man-made structures such as harbors, buildings, and bridges. We need a more complete and systematic way to help us for guiding and maneuvering, for example, the coastal, port entrance, and anywhere else in the water area. We need a system that can tell us about the danger site, such as wreck under it, and the accurate on time of depth data. If you can see, at some places there are buoys that help the vessel to maneuver its way into the passage. So to do this, hydrographer collected all data for several years about a particular place and its surrounding, then compile it. Now we have a good system that have all of this information that we call ECDIS, which we are going to discuss about it later. These are some differences between nautical chart and a topographic map for you to understand more about the chart. Another thing to consider in hydrographic survey is the tidal level, as the tide will affect directly to the measurement of the water depth. The lowest tide that can be predicted to occur under average meteorological condition is called as lowest astronomical tide, LAT. It can be obtained properly by studying tidal predictions covering ideally within 18.6 years. And the highest level which can be predicted to occur under average meteorological condition is called as highest astronomical tide, HAT. Tide can be measured manually by using tide pole or automatically by tide gauge. This is example of diagram on transferring reduced level from benchmark to on top of the tide pole. And this is the diagram on installation of digital tide gauge. These are few tide levels that are normally used to describe tide at certain periods of times. We have here mean sea level, MSL, mean high water spring, MHWS, and mean low water spring MLWS. And the other are mean high water nip MHWN and mean low water nip MLWN. You could draw and label to help you remember this diagram. To help us to calculate the correction of water depth, we can use the method of reduced depth to land survey datum LSD, where measured depth from survey will be deducted with the established land survey datum from the nearest established benchmark height. The corrected water depth is called as reduced depth. The advantage of reduced sounding refers to land survey datum is that it can merge with land details refer to the vertical datum from established benchmark. Another type of correction is the charted depth refer to the chart datum, CD, where measured depth from survey will be deducted with the datum plane that is adopted from the national authority from its published chart or tidal prediction. Alert that the surveyor cannot establish this chart datum in the field. The corrected water depth in respect to chart datum is called as charted depth. These are some examples of chart datum at standard ports. Last but not least, the correction in respect to the sounding datum. The measured depth is reduced in the course of survey sounding datum, and it is normally used when compiling the fair chart or final tracing. This is the datum which the field survey will establish and adopt, and ideally, it should be near to as the chart datum. For sounding datum, there are three ways to obtain it. First is to recover a previous established sounding or chart datum in the survey area by leveling from benchmark. Secondly, by transfer datum from a place close to the survey area where chart datum or sounding datum is already established by taking simultaneous tidal observation over a period of time. And thirdly, if the too early option is not available, then just establish a new datum from observation. For a proper sounding datum selection, a few considerations should be taken into account, like the datum should be low enough, which should always at least as much water as is shown in the chart. The datum also should agree with the established level of chart datum and should always be in harmony with the datum of adjacent survey. Another thing is, care must be taken not to establish datum by erecting pole or gauge where the water becomes impounded at low water level. This is a diagram shows basically what activities are involved in hydrographic survey. For hydrographic survey work to be completed, it must go through 5 stages. Started from preparation, which includes the planning of survey and reconnaissance. Then the calibration process, which to eliminate any pertinent errors. The second stage is the data collection. Before the survey starts, double check and verify all equipment are ready. During the survey, monitor the data collected and equipment conditions. After the survey has been carried out, the next stage is data processing. This is where data cleaning and selection take place. Don't forget to do and include all information needed for data corrections. The first three stages have high cost and need to be planned properly. The fourth stage is the data analysis. Here, the data quality is thoroughly processed in order to yield answer to the purpose of the survey. But sometimes, good data can be processed to meet the purpose of other study as well. And finally, the rendering stage. This is where the information yield from the survey are ready to be documented and shared to the interested party in several types of format. Additional information related to the correction parts. As hydrographic survey is a process that's supposed to occur on water, beside the tidal effects, to ensure that the vessel is always in the correct position, satellite assistance such as GPS will help to position each depth reading recorded correctly by the system. Due to the influence of water and weather, the moving vessel also does not escape to the motion errors during the data collection. It is known as 6 degree of freedom. And to overcome this, some vessels are equipped with the initial measurement unit IMU to compensate the motion of vessel. This is some example of typical single beam echo sounding bathymetry data collection. This is a schematic diagram showing roughly on how a nautical chart is produced from several instruments such as echo sounder and side scan sonar with the aid of correction information from certain data such as tidal, vessel draft, vessel location and movement. The hydrography survey process data and compilation also needs to follow certain minimum standards to ensure that the provided data can represent and satisfy the needs of user. These are the brief guidelines that should be followed based on its requirement of order. It includes the horizontal accuracy, depth accuracy, line spacing, and others. Besides, in order to include some features in the created map, we should follow some standards that has been outlined. Another additional info, there are two categories of competence hydrographer which are called as Cat B and the higher one is Cat A, according to the FIGN IHO. So, from the data collected in hydrographic survey, what are the advantages and applications that we can utilize them? Well, hydrography data are essential to a multitude of other activities such as global studies, shoreline erosion and sediment transport studies, coastal construction and dredging, delimitations of maritime boundaries, environmental protection and pollution control, exploration and exploitation of marine resources, and development of marine geographic information system. And some of the information from the survey is very useful as an update to the Notice to Mariner NTM. This notice is an advice to all mariners of important matters that affecting navigational safety within that area. For example, it provides new hydrographic information, changes in channel and aids to navigation. And finally, from the effort by the combination of several systems, we have got this sophisticated system called as ECDIS, a system that can provide us a complete information for navigations. ECDIS stands for Electronic Chart Display and Information System. The basic system is provided by the Electronic Navigational Chart, ENC. This ENC then integrates with all system requires for navigations like GPS and AIS, make up a really helpful tool on deck. The electronic navigational chart is basically formed by the raster and vector format of data. These combinations provide us with comprehensive images and current situation of an area that we are heading. The system will provide us a real-time navigation system and do some navigational decision automatically. Not just that, it will alert us with alarm system for the unseen hazard as we are heading towards it. But sometimes, as electronic equipment, even a great tool like ECDIS also can face difficulties, and it should be assessed from time to time. The area of risk for ECDIS include the equipment itself, where it may suffer from potential virus infection, power outages, and loss of input of sensory equipment. And sometimes, the chart display on it was expired, out-of-date chart is being used, and updates not applied correctly, and other faulty like excessive zooming. The hazard caused from ECDIS can be classified into three types, which are minor hazard like interruption to navigation information and reduced functionality. Secondly, major hazard like severe disruption to navigation information and loss of alarm function. And finally, critical hazard, which is ECDIS system failure, which the vessel should be handled manually by the captain command. Up to the end, now, due to the technology development, we also have an application that available online too. For example, this marine traffic apps. It helps to suggest the route that's safe to navigate, while in smaller space and busy area, it shows more detail of the destination. For example, we take over here, when we are approaching a port clang, the apps show on timely basis what is going on in the port, how many ships are there, and many others related information for us to navigate through the port. So that's it. That's all for the chapter. Thank you.